In this video, we are going to discuss the measures of dispersion, which include standard deviation, variance, range, and interquartile range. And we'll be calculating these using Google Sheets. So let's get started. All right, we're looking at measures of dispersion. And there's four different types that we'll be looking at here. And the first one is standard deviation. So to calculate the standard deviation of a sample set of data, so let's just assume that this is a sample set of data, we will use the following function. STDEV, I'll put it equal in there because we're using a function, equals STDEV dot S for sample. And then we're going to select the data. So that's the function we're using. Now, it is possible that you may be dealing with a population set of data. It should be pretty obvious based on the context of the problem if you're dealing with a population or a sample. So anyways, I'll just be assuming this is a sample set of data, because typically if you're given data, it's a sample and it's not an entire population of data. So if you're using a population, if you're trying to find the population standard deviation, it's the same function, but you put a P instead of an S here after the period. Okay, so let's go ahead and find the sample standard deviation equals STDEV dot S. There it is there. And now we're going to select the data, close parentheses. All right, so standard deviation of 10.3 and so many decimals. And so keep in mind, just in general, that, and this applies to variance also, that if you have a larger standard deviation is telling you that the data, the sample data, is spread out more. A larger standard deviation represents the data being spread out more. Dispersion, measures of dispersion we're talking about here. And standard deviation is representing the spread of the data. If you have a smaller standard deviation, that means the data is more tightly bound. They're closer together. So smaller standard deviation represents smaller dispersion of data. Now let's go ahead and look at variance. Equals VAR dot S. And then select the data. And I'll put a apostrophe here. So there's the variance function that we'll be using, equals var.s. And very similar to standard deviation, and you may have saw this here, there's a dot p if you're dealing with a variance of an entire population. We're assuming this is a sample. Okay, now we will select the data, close parentheses. Hit enter. Now, one thing to note here, and I'll show you off to the side here, that the variance is standard deviation squared. And I'm going to go ahead and show you equals the standard deviation, and I'm going to raise that to the second power, and notice that we'll get the same value as variance. So standard deviation squared is variance. So similarly, if you have a larger variance, kind of like if you square a larger value, it's going to be larger, and square a small value, it's still going to be kind of small. So same idea with standard deviation. With variance, if you have a larger variance, the data is more spread out. If you have a smaller variance, the data is less spread out, less dispersed. Okay, so let's look at range. Now we have to use a combination of two functions here. And there are functions that we would look at back at the five-number summary to calculate. The range involves the max and the min. So I'm going to show you a different function besides quartile. And I've mentioned this before, that that you may have multiple functions that can be used for a single value we're solving for. So equals max. We can actually find the maximum. So I'm going to open parenthesis. I'm going to actually put an apostrophe there. There we go. And then we'll select the data. And then we're going to subtract the min select the data. So there's our function. So we're going to do equals maximum. So it's the distance from the largest value to the smallest value. So we're going to select the data and then subtract the min, open parenthesis, select the data again. We want the min of this data set. And as you can see, we have found the max to be 60, the min to be 20, which you can actually see here since the data is already sorted. So we're going to get 40. So as you can kind of imagine with measures of dispersion, how spread out your data is, the range calculates how far the max is from the min. So if your data is more spread out, chances are the range is going to be larger. If the data is less spread out, then the data the range will probably be smaller. So same idea with standard deviation variance. Now, I'm going to do a comparison between standard deviation variance compared to range and interquartile range. But let's look at interquartile range first. So equals IQR, apostrophe, and it's not IQR, equals, now it's something we've already calculated before, Q3 and Q1. So actually, as I mentioned, Q3 and Q1 we're using a very specific method to calculate these. So we want to use the same exact function we used up here. Or method, I should say. So it's equals quartile largest half of data. Actually, I'll go ahead and reference it above up here to figure out how to find Q3 and Q1, but I'm just going to write Q3 minus Q1. And then you can look up here to figure out how to find Q3 and Q1. Now to find this, we're going to do, I'm going to just reference these cells up here since it's the same exact method, same exact function, unlike before with like, I'm using max and min here, a different function. So I'm just going to do equals Q3 minus Q1. And that is 16. So this is taking the 75th percentile, the 75% all of the way down these sorted values, minus the value that's located at the 25th percentile, Q1, 25% of the way down the values, and subtracting and finding the interquartile range. All right, now just a note, something, a good observation to notice here. Measures of dispersion, the first two, standard deviation and variance. Notice when you calculate the standard deviation and variance. Actually, it's not that obvious, but keep in mind that standard deviation and variance, if you were to do this by hand, you'll notice that that the standard deviation variance takes into consideration every single data value when you do the calculation. You're looking at every single data value. Every single data value is used to calculate this. Unlike, and variance is the same way. Range and interquartile range is not that case, is not taken into consideration every single data value because the range only looks at the max and the min. It does not look at everything in between. And the interquartile range only looks at the 75th percentile, the Q3, and only looks at the Q1. So standard deviation and variance are in some ways more powerful. It tells you more about your data because it looks at all of your data when it calculates it. So these are more, standard deviation and variance are more commonly used in statistics. Okay, so anyways, hopefully this helps. We have now discussed the measures of dispersion with these four different calculations.